Yep. It snowed. And a bunch. And it's cold. Calendar says March. Weather thinks otherwise. Let's get into all the details. That is your Kentucky One Health weather bug camera from the Lexington Center. Triangle Park is nicely snow covered. Keep in mind, we're what, a month away from Keeneland and we're still dealing with this? So there you go. Might even be less than a month at this point. You were looking at a max track cloud Doppler, a couple little sprinkles, northern Bath County up into Fleming County, and they are sprinkles at this point. You were looking at the snow. It's a top 10 daffodil destroyer. You're like everything else, they're just knocked over with all that heavy snow. Midweek, another cold shot's coming. That's the word you wanted to hear. The 8-day, there is not much spring anywhere around. So the snowfall. Call this a thumper, where it was moving along nicely, and then it got into central Kentucky and essentially put the brakes on, and then the snow started to dump. And so you see that 6 to 10 inch band, which included Lexington and a lot of communities surrounding, as far to the southwest as northern Taylor County, as far to the east as parts of Morgan and Menifee County. Didn't get a whole lot north of I-64 with that, and a 3 to 6 inch band covers that, and it dropped off really fairly quickly as you got into southern Kentucky. For Lexington, the official snow total, 3 inches yesterday, 6 inches today, 9 inches total. Fayette County in general, 5 to 10 inches, depending on exactly where you were. Now, my house on the south side, I had 5.5. Might have been pushing 6, might have been a little compaction, but that's all I measured. But I know Kevin said he measured 10 over on the east side, so there you go. Madison County, 6 to 10. Clark County was 6 to 10. Garrett County, 6 to 8. Boyle, the same. Same in Estill. Powell was 4 to 8. Lee, 4 to 7. Anderson County, 4 to 6. Sean Wilson called that 6-inch in for us out of Anderson County. Rockcastle County, 3 to 7. Scott County was 3 to 6. Franklin County was only 2 to 5. So where do we sit with all this? The 9 inches total? Well, the 6 inches of today makes today the 9th snowiest March day that we've ever seen. The 9 inches total, we're already in the top 10 snowiest March. And the view from space is breathtaking. There you go. The clouds sweep out. The snow left in the wake. Just a terrific picture. That's the new GOES 16 look. Watch everything pivot. So we've got a center point right here. See, instead of it pushing away, it sat and spun for a while. That's how we got the big snow totals, and now starting to clear things out. And this is turning into another nor'easter. 3 of them in 2 weeks. We're going to see that develop and hit the folks over there in New England again. For us, we've got a reinforcing cold front. You may commence cheering now. That'll drop through during the day tomorrow. As it does, sprinkles and flurries will be associated with it. We get a really cold day on Wednesday before a little bit of moderation will eventually arrive. At the moment, we're sitting in the 30s and 40s, 41 at the Bluegrass Airport with a wind chill of 33. So for tonight, cloudy, cooler. Watch out for black ice. There are going to be the possibility of a few flurries as well. We'll be in the upper 20s tomorrow. Cloudy and cold and a few flurries or sprinkles. We may touch 40, but then we're back to the mid-30s on Wednesday. Low 50s Thursday. Rain returns on Friday. At this point, there's at least a shower possibility for St. Patrick's Day on Saturday.
But maybe we can dodge it for all the fun activities.
For the parade and everything else.
Yeah. Thanks, Bill. Yep.